Today we're starting the vertical stabilizer. And first thing I did was find all my parts and then you have to flatten them. So these are not flat against the table, and that's because when they bend them, I guess it has a tendency to bend that way. So in the RANS kit, they do supply some fluting pliers, which basically just have a notch, I don't know, like a male and a female notch in them. So when you squeeze them, it makes the long area shorter, you know, puts little dog legs in them. And your first thought would be like, okay, put the long, see the nose is not the same length, so put the long nose going this way, but that's actually wrong. They do that on purpose because they don't want you to bend down at the crease point. So you actually put the long side on the inside. You just kind of gently work your way around till they're all flush. So a little more to go on this side. I was uploading the video, that's why I didn't videotape the first part. I don't know if you can tell, but as I squeeze this, it actually pulls it the other way. It's pretty cool. And obviously you don't want to squeeze it too much. But you do want it to be straight. The other thing you want to do is make sure that the edges are perpendicular or square. For the most part, these look to be right on. One done. So what I do is I just go in the middle of each one. Give it a little bend. Kind of feel it. Might have to go over it and do it twice. What I'm trying to avoid doing is bending them unevenly. I want to bend them all kind of the same. Alright, I'll speed this up. Okie dokie. Now I've flattened all of these pieces out so they sit pretty flat. Rivet flanges are perpendicular to the rib itself. These little ones, this one needed a little bit, but these ones obviously didn't. And now they're asking us to clico them together. And it says, refer to figure 003-03 for spar riveting schedule. Click of the frame assembly together as shown in the parts manual drawing. Parts manual drawing, click of. Number three is probably this guy. 110. Nope. Am I reading this right? Vertical, okay, so vertical fin, top nose rib, KPVS 0100. 010. KPVS 0100. The next one is the spar 103, which is this guy. 103, got it? Oh, wait, I wrote on it. Three. It must be this guy then. Yeah, there we go. Vertical fin nose rib number 3, KPVS 0110. 0110. So, what does this say? Thank goodness for Clicos, huh? Hey guys. Anybody Clico one-handed? That'd be helpful. Would have been some kind of tool that allows you to do it. Or once you're super experienced, like me, I mean, I've been doing this for at least almost a week now. You put the Clico in before you set up the parts. Four. Does it look like four? Four. That top one's supposed to be bent like that? Looks it. Four. Way down here, doesn't sound good. Well, the holes line up down there, so. Lead me to believe it might be okay. Good idea labeling these parts with the numbers. I just want to make a mistake, I suppose. Oh, wait. Oh, I'm supposed to click all through all these. All right, so we're six. drinking. Alright, I'm already confused. Let me figure this out. I figured it out because I'm super smart. I was trying to click with this side onto here, but because of the angle, obviously it wouldn't go. So I just flipped it around. So it's not quite level, but I think it should be good. So we got 7. Okay, so 7 and 3. Alright, so those go together. So this is 10. Wow, it's gonna go through a lot of clicos. Okay, so all in. Okay, so I'm gonna get this right. I'm just gonna put those two in to hold that. And then supposedly I got 5 on this end, which goes flanges facing down, pinch to zoom, into the very lower one along with 9. Okay. See if those Clecos even go that long. Look at this left-handed Cleco. They do.
Would you look at that? Just look at it.
Definitely could benefit from a bigger screen here. All right, so these go. Okay. Alright, so I did this wrong. I was trying to figure out. They both have holes right there. Oh, no, I did that right. So 17 goes through those. Okay. Oh. Okay, I got it. So this is the forward spar assembly, which is this guy, and here they tell you these are all 42 rivets and 42 here, and then once it gets to the doubler it's 44, and then at the very bottom these two are 46s. Got it. Holes go on the bottom, the flanges go forward. Right, it looks like we just have to put those into place. 13, 14, and 15. Something like that.
Piece of cake.
Oh, I think that's under there. There it goes. 15. You know, they should put the clecos in the direction that you're supposed to rivet. Because, if not, we'll rivet the other way. So. I might figure it out since I can't fit the rivet gun in there. This is so cool. It's like already taking shape. Oh yeah, so I need these guys. Okay, so these ones are gonna go. So these are 16. Four of these guys. These are the same bushings that we used on the rudder. One, two. Three, four. Set up my super vise. But these are going to get pushed in from the other side. So, like that. Mess this up because I don't think those guys are going to come out if they do. That's very satisfying. It even looks straight. Yeah, these are the big ones, right? It's not it. Not to overstate the obvious, these are color coded. These are like 1/8 inch, the copper ones, probably the most popular ones, and then they go up in size from there. My trusted friend, hello. She's the only one who keeps me company doing this. All right, so I just test fitted the skin. And the holes line up pretty good. Some of the spars obviously have a little bit, not the spars, but the ribs have a little bit of give to them. And I'm going to pull this off. And then rivet the inside structure of the ribs and the spars together. Take all the stickers off. Kind of bummed that this has the writing on the outside, because it says in the manual that wherever they can, they put the writing on the inside, unless I have two left skins. So that was close. These bottom section here, where the double plates are, require the 44 rivets, size 44, AAPQ-44. And in order to fit the three across the bottom, I took this rib plate out. Say to do this, but I suppose you can rivet them from the other side as well, but I don't know, I did it this way. Now I'm slowly but surely starting to take all these stickers off. And if you remember, my lovely daughter stuck all the stickers on my back, so we've kind of been going back and forth. I took them off my back and I stuck them on her mirror. This morning I woke up and I went on the computer and they were stuck all over my computer screen. So the original stickers actually came from Home Depot. So now I'm going to collect all these, and tonight when she's sleeping I'm going to stick them all over her. even though that might backfire, because one thing I've learned is everything I dish out to her, I get back threefold, so it's all in good fun. Okay, so those are all riveted. Oh, wait. Put this guy back on. Anyway. I think that's it for the 1/8-inch rivets. Now we're going to go for the 64. Rivet the spars, hinges, and ribs using appropriate hardware. Prefer. Okay. Yeah, we need 8 of these. Just double checking. 64. Oh, wait, 64, 68. Ah, Confucius say, pay attention. So we'll put these back. These are the 20s. We have 4 20s going up here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, look at this. I got one that's labeled in here. Oh, that's the one I messed up with the other gun. Alright, so those go there. And then, it must be these guys.
There you go.
Would you look at that? Just look at it. I need 4 and there is 4. I'm so excited. Alright. And the difference is the shank is longer. Well, because we're going through thick hinge, thin metal, thick backer. And thick backer at your lot. And up there, we're just going through that. Now we gotta change this tip again. Yeah, I know. Is it this one? Hold on. Alright, so here we go. Long mamas go in the deep hole. Look at the clippers. Look how far in they push. Hope I don't mess up. I only have 4 to make 4 holes. This lines up. I want to like stick a bolt through there or something. supposed to line up. Because we got a bolt going through there later. I'm gonna do that. I just want to stick a drill bit through there. To take the sticker off. Corrosion would have gathered under there. Moisture would have gathered under there. It would have corroded the aluminum, caused the bottom of the rudder to fall off. Jenna, you're getting stuck tonight. Yeah. I already have this in there, can't be that hard. Alright, so the thinking here is I basically put this in there just to make sure that's lined up. So I know when this part goes into the rudder, it's really hard to get that screw in there. And I think if that's not lined up, that's going to be a big pain in the butt. I suppose we could also add one of these guys. Just to now we'll be able to get the things in the rivets. Oh, Derek, what are you doing? Okay. Here we go. That Slim Shady in the background there. Haven't heard this song in decades. Oh, now you have it. It still moves. Not as smooth as it did before, but. I hope the bolts go through. Definitely tell these stainless. Way beefier than the other aluminum ones. Like the gun's almost struggling to get them in. All right, time to read the instructions. So I just realized I forgot to put these two guys in, which I did. They are shorter rivet. This is kind of creased here. Came like that. I don't know why or if it's an issue. Hopefully not. But moving along in the instructions, they go the side skins to the frame assembly. Side skins. Frame assembly. So I know I kind of did this earlier. A little bit. And gonna do it again. A little bit more. And I know I just started here, but use an edge forming tool to form the aft edge of the leading edge skin. Leading edge, aft edge forming tool. And I know Eddie said he doesn't really like this, and I ordered the little cookie puck, two of them actually, but they're not here until next week sometime. So I figured I'd give this a try, but it actually seems to work okay. It's just modified vice grips.
So it only goes, there's this little mark here. Nothing on there, but... I'm not sure if I'm supposed to run it down twice. What that does is it just kind of convinces the edge to go in and not out. It's definitely easier to pull it towards you than away from you. At least it's more controllable. As I say that, I'm on track here. I almost wish it had a longer guide for these straight edges. I feel like I'm teeter-tottering like this quite a bit. And if you... Yeah, see, like, kind of rolled off there. That's pretty good. Was the lighting or oh. Well, of course it is. Perfect. I don't know about these lines, but okay. Click over the leading edge skin to the frame assembly overlapping the side skins. I can do that. If these are off, like way off. I must have like crooked them too much. Not when I say way off, they're just not as perfect as the other ones.
all rounded, so you can't measure straight or not.
All right, time to call in the experts again. I was kind of stuck on this yesterday where it says, check the vertical stab for twists by placing clecos in the holes on the end ribs and using a straight edge and digital level to compare. So I got that. So I put the clecos on the end rib, and I was trying to figure out on how they want us to compare it. Well, I brought in the intelligent crew, and they're like, there's actually holes on this side. So we found these holes, and basically we're just gonna put something across here and level it, and conveniently enough, there's holes. All right, real quick, looks like the battery was dying. But then we have holes here as well, all the way up to there, so. Okay, got a little charge in the battery. Check the vertical stab for twist by placing clecos in the holes on the end ribs. Well, I did that. And then I had to have my daughter explain to me that they're talking about these holes in the end ribs. Okay, that makes sense. So I can level something across here and then level something across on the other side. Because this has holes as well. And that just makes so much more sense. Let me show you about the stickers. So remember the sticker revenge? This is what happens when all the stickers end up in her car. Her car. Her bed. Don't mess with a teenager. Alright, we'll try this again. So earlier today I came down and I wanted to talk about this part right here. Check the vertical stab for twist by placing clecos in the holes on the end ribs and use a straight edge and digital level to compare. If needed, use boards to weight, blah, blah, blah. And I couldn't figure out how, okay, my battery was dead. So problem number one, I'm like, wait a minute, I had this thing on the charger all night. So here's the charger. Here's my professional photography setup. Here's the cord, and the cord actually taps into the light. So what I didn't realize, or I forgot, is that every time I shut the lights off at night, it's not charging, which is why my battery was dead. So, back to the level. Then Jenna came down, and we looked at this again. And I thought, oh, I got all these clecos in the end ribs. But then I found these little holes here. And I said, that must be it. So, we put clecos in those. I assume they're centered. And then I just cut this piece of straight-edge aluminum, and I put a level on it. I spaced this up on this aluminum block. So this is stout and level and true. And then I went over, yep, always in the way, to the other side, did the same thing. So here I'm using all three of these and basically leveled that in. I had to ever so slightly, like if it sits, I don't know if you can tell, it's just a hair bit off. So I just had to massage this. You get, actually, this is kind of cool because you can tell. Oh, it's hard to tell, but it does. Without moving the other side, I can flex this probably about 2 degrees in either direction if I force it. And you can see the skin moving as I do that. So I see what they're saying now. So I move that in there. And I know this is just a small level, but it fits in here. I put it both ways just to make sure it's accurate. And that seems to work pretty good. And I think somehow I would like this to connect with these, but I haven't quite figured out how to do that. Maybe I can just put a little bar across there. So I figured out how to level this, and it looks to be pretty level. I haven't riveted this yet, because I'm looking to do the optional pull handle assembly. So I collected all the parts, and I was a bit confused because we have 4 things checked off here in this little bag, which is the pull handle raw stock kit, and this 7/8 tube has number 106 on it. Then you got 106.1, 106-2, and 106-3. So I was looking for four parts, but in this kit was only three parts. I haven't confirmed this yet, but I'm thinking, because the little asterisk here says for -1, -2, -3, it's part of the raw stock kit. So with that being said, I think 106 is it. I don't know why they have it as a separate part. It's the kit with three pieces in it, so there's only three pieces. And it kind of makes sense, because I'm thinking this goes inside the juju. This, wait, let me get this straight again. Because the handle fits on this, and I think this will probably be a double piece inside the handle. Then the thin piece goes inside the airplane wing. That's my guess. We'll see if I'm right or not. Then the next step is to separate these two. And I basically just ran it through the table saw. Now I'm just going to file the edges clean. All right. Changed positions a little bit there. Probably a little too far up at the other angle. So they want you to put this doubler right on it's good I had this this piece laying around, because it actually shows you where the hole is, because my initial thought was maybe it's on this bar or up here or whatever, but it does go there. The instructions just tell you to put it on the skin. But and I already did the other side, so this side's gonna go a little easier. I'm always overthinking everything. Alright, so that one's right there. Then you match drill that with a number 30. Humor them, 3/4 inch hole. I know I just moved the whole assembly, but it doesn't matter right now. ¾ inch, so we'll be at 3/8. I'm just going to do this the way I did the other side. This is actually a 7/8 uni bit that goes up to 7/8, but it started out nice and sharp, brand new DeWalt. And in my experience, even though you start in the center, if you put tension going one way, you can walk the bit into whatever direction. So basically just drilling it bigger and making sure. It stays centered. Okay, that looks really good. Because I don't want to put the 3/4 inch hole into the skin and then mar up the 3/4 inch hole in the doubler. I'm going to go back to my older uni bit, which is a 3/4 inch, and should go down in there smooth. I almost want to do this on a router table with the tracing bit. Yeah. The inside. So I guess you could do this if this was all riveted, because I read a step ahead. You're gonna take this off, stick the tube in, glue together, stick the tube in, and then do that. So hopefully tonight I'll get this riveted. I don't have any JB weld, and I could get some I forgot, which I'll save for tomorrow. All right, quick summary. I ended up riveting this side. I have not done the other side yet. I'll probably do a time lapse there. There's a few scratches in here. Not for me. I guess we gotta sand these out if they're grabbable by the nail. The back side that goes into the aft spar was a little misleading because they wanted you to use the longer Cherry Q rivets, 42s, but they all protrude just a little bit. I did try a shorter one, which is the 41, and it seemed to be fine and sit good. I know going into the spar here, we're using the longer ones, the 42s, but it's going through two pieces of skin and into the spar, and these sit nice. These are the shorter ones. These sit nice. These are the longer ones that go going into the thicker spar material, but they protrude just a little bit. I've looked at this 10 times, 17 to the 42s. So a little confused there, but I went ahead and riveted them all. Most of them went in really, really nice. A couple of them I had to massage a little bit. I think this forward rib, the one with the two, had it was just bent. I don't know, it was just tweaked a little bit, so I just stuck a long post, that little aluminum rod from the top through the upper rib, and I was able to push it down to line it up. And that's it. So tomorrow we're going to check, make sure it's still level. We'll flip it over on the other side, make sure it's still level, and then do that side. I'll probably do a time lapse on that. So today I leveled the other side, riveted the other side. And before I did that, I remembered I had this handy dandy laser level at the shop. So I brought that home and, kind of wiggling it here, but just basically verified that those marking holes are totally level. And No, obviously I had to set the laser level up here, and I did this side as well, and these are level as well. And then I went through and drilled out all of these holes, match drilled them, and then I took it all apart again, got any of the shavings out that are inside, all little drill droppings, and basically just cleaned them, deburred them, and riveted it all. So the skins are riveted onto the vertical stabilizer, and tomorrow we'll do this little doohickey.